Hi, this is Kevin Bacon, and today I'm going to show you how I do cheap and easy thermal cooking with a rocket stove. Everything you'll see today I already had except for the food. So if you look in previous videos, you'll find my rocket stoves. You'll see me cooking on rocket stoves, but today we're going to add another dimension to it. We're going to thermal cook it. Okay, let's get started. First thing we need is something to cook, and we're going to do Great Northern beans. So I'm going to do ham and beans on the rocket stove, thermal cooked. Okay. Second thing we need is a rocket stove and a pot to cook them in. Now I have already washed these beans according to the directions on the bag. That's a 2-pound bag, so there's a bunch of them in there. This is a large pot, and it's got a bunch of water in it. Now the first thing we've got to do is get that water and those beans up to a boil for what they call a pre-soak. And the pre-soak, you get the water up to a good roaring boil, and then you let it set for an hour, and it gets the beans soft and ready to go. Then you're going to rinse them, and then you're going to actually do your cooking. So let's get a fire going and get on toward our pre-soak. Now that I got the rocket stove burning, I'm going to put a pot surround around that pot, because otherwise the wind is going to blow most of my flame out here to the side, and I want the flames to be right in the middle of the pot. So I just got an old piece of aluminum flashing, and I'm just going to drop it around there. Aluminum is not my favorite choice, because if it gets too close to the flame, it will deform or even melt sometimes. But that's what I got today, so we're going to put it up there for a windshield and get on about the cooking. The pot shield's in place. The wind is coming from over there, so I left the back of it open because it's not big enough to cover the whole thing. Now I'm going to dump in the beans. 2 pounds washed, sorted beans, minus about 4 of them that fell on the ground. Now, we're just going to cook that until it comes to a good boil. Remember, a boil is a boil. A rip-roaring boil is 212 degrees. A little bitty boil is 212 degrees. So don't waste a bunch of fuel trying to get a rip-roaring boil. Just get a good steady boil, and that'll save you some fuel. Quick look in here at the fire. There's absolutely no smoke coming out of this cooker. Up here on top, no smoke. There's a tiny little bit of soot. You look over there, you can see the heat shimmer in the reflection. But standing here, and I'm standing downwind from it, I can't even smell the fire. That's a good rocket stove. Don't forget to give these beans a good stir once in a while so they don't scald and stick to the bottom. Scalded potatoes and scalded beans really aren't very tasty. Got steam and bubbles coming on. Good stir here. It's pretty close to a boil. There's about somewhere between 8 and 10 quarts of water in there, so it takes a fair long time. I want you to notice that these handles are inside of this particular pot shield, so don't grab those with your bare hands or you're going to get burnt. I brought some pot holders out here to handle that. Okay, there's our boil. Nice and steady up the middle, you can see it. Now on to the next step. Remember, this is just pre-soak. And there's the next step. Grab a couple of hot holders. Now in the bottom of this cooler is the bottom of that towel, and I've also got an egg carton so that it doesn't touch directly on the bottom of the plastic. You just cover that up like that, stuff that in there, close that up, put this nice big hunk of crystal on top of it to hold the lid shut. And we're going to forget this for an hour. But we're not done. We got other things to do. We got right at an hour now before that comes out of there. So we're going to cut up some celery. I'm going to chop up some garlic. I'm going to drain a couple cans of black beans and rinse them. And I've got some salt-free seasoning here. We're going to use salt-free seasoning. Garlic powder, but I don't think we're going to need it. I'm going to use a large clove of elephant garlic. Now, elephant garlic is not nearly as strong as regular garlic, so that will easily work in there. I got some black pepper here, and this says garlic on top, but it's really ginger. So if you come to my house and you think you're getting garlic, you might be getting ginger. So those are our main ingredients that we're going to put in here. I'm going to chop the celery all up, and we're going to not throw any of it away, because whatever we don't use here, or whatever is waste, like the heels here, will go in the worm bin. Nothing gets wasted. Oh yeah, that's right. We said ham and beans, didn't we? So two more ingredients. We got a ham there on a bone. I'm going to chop the ham off it and dice it up into little cubes. And right next to that, we got some Chinese red pepper. The hour soak is done, so it's time to yank it out of here. Drain the beans, rinse the beans, fill it back up with water. Put her back on the stove. Now let's see how we're doing in here. Oh yeah. Well, the handles have cooled down. Now I can handle it by the handles. So I'm going to take this in, drain it, rinse it, fill it back up, and bring her back out. Okay, the elephant garlic didn't work, so I'm going to use some of these garlic heads that I showed on a previous video. We'll just peel them open, and inside you're going to see a bunch of little garlic like mini cloves, and I'm just going to split those up and throw them in with the rest of the beans. Beans are in fresh, clean water. I'm going to rip up these garlic heads here and throw them in. See, they're little beads about the size of a BB shot. As you get them coming loose, they'll just go right in there like that. See? I'm gonna put all three of them in there. I'm going to add in my ham and celery. A little Chinese red pepper for heat. Little ginger. Some black pepper. This is Tony Chachere's salt-free seasoning. Add a little bit of that. There's probably enough salt in that ham, but we're not going to add any extra salt. Put the lid on it and start cooking just like we were before. Don't forget, 2 cans of black beans, rinsed and drained. Stir it all up. We want to make sure we keep the level below the top of these rivets here on this particular pan, because otherwise the rivets will leak. Now there's a little over 10 quarts there, so that ought to make quite a huge meal. I let the fire go out while we were letting the beans soak, but since this stove has such tremendous insulation inside of it, it takes very, very little to start it again. It had an instant draft, and the stove's going already. It took me maybe 2 minutes to get a new fire going. So on to the boil. Okay, whatever you do, see how I put that spoon on there? Don't do that. That spoon handle will get so hot it'll burn you really, really well. Really good. A whole lot. Bad. Not good. Okay, nice ripping boil. We're going to kind of simmer this long for 10 minutes and then on to the next step. Little trick you might try if you want to keep it from boiling over is just add a little oil to the top of the water, olive oil or something like that, and that'll keep a foam from forming and boiling over the top. Now I've got the top kind of cracked open just a little bit there to keep the foam from coming up to the edge. Be ready to transfer it over to the cooker in just a couple minutes. Okay, our time is up and we're going to transfer it now into the slow cooker. Throw the towel over the top. Put the lid on. Hop on the brick, and that's where it's going to stay for, 2.5, 3 hours, 4 hours, however long you want to leave it in there, but I suspect at least 3 hours to get these beans nice and tender, and then we'll take it out of here and we'll get a look. Okay, let me give you an idea of the wood usage. These are two boards. They're 1/2 inch thick. They're about 4 inches wide, and they're about 3 feet long. And I've got that much wood left over after having burned two of those. So it took about 1.5 of those boards down there, and those are just, I call it scab wood, box wood, to cook this meal. And it's still got a good fire going down in there. So if you wanted to do a little more heating up of something, you could easily do it. So that's all the wood it took to make this meal. A little over 2 hours. Now it's time to get a look. And let's see what we got inside. Took off the rock. Lift up the lid. Now that is hot. I'm telling you, hot. Oh yeah, oh yeah, those beans are done. No doubt about it. So, a little over 2 hours in the wow, look at that. I wish you could smell it. A little over 2 hours in the cooler. And we're ready to eat. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Good eats. So that's it right there. An old picnic cooler, a towel, a pot, a rocket stove, a couple sticks, and some raw food materials, and we got supper for not very much. Thanks for watching. Bye. Yum.